Welcome to 3rd and 21. This is a show we do two things. Talk about college football, try to have a little fun. On this show, we're going to talk on a high level about the national championship game. Go to the recently neglected mailbag, but ever popular mailbag, and do some other fun things. Before we do that, let's go around the country, talk about some teams not in the KPI top 12. This segment we like to call hashtag thumbs up, thumbs down.
Thumbs up!
Thumbs up the 2019 season. If you remember, before the season started, it was all, who's going to win, Alabama or Clemson? Everybody else is playing for third and fourth place. That didn't work out, but 2019 did give us a lot of great games, some upsets. The rivalries, of course, were there. You had some teams that went way above what we expected them to do, Illinois. Some teams that did not get to what we thought they were going to do. Looking at you again, Texas. But all in all, fantastic season. I'll never forget you, 2019.
Thumbs down.
Starting the national championship game at 8:30. Look, if you're a student in college or you're in your 20s, that's fine. But that's too late to start a game. Come on. Mush.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. Staying up to the finish when you are watching a national championship game. This game was decided early in the fourth quarter. A lot of people bugged out and went to bed. Knowing LSU was going to win, it's just what was the final score going to be. No. You don't do that. You stay up to the end. You watch the players hugging each other. You watch the trophy presentation. You watch the losing coach give his press conference. Then you turn the TV off and you go to bed like I did at 1:30 in the morning.
Thumbs down.
This insane notion put forward on Twitter that Trevor Lawrence is somehow overrated and not the quarterback everybody thought he was going to be reaffirms my long-standing position that the worst of humanity lives on social media.
Thumbs up!
Don't know if you saw it, but Arizona State re-upped Herm Edwards. The Herm Edwards experience is working at Arizona State. We've got a lot of work to do, a lot of computer models, a lot of research before we come out with the preseason favorites, but I am leaning as Arizona State to be the Pac-12 South preseason favorite in the KPI top 12.
Thumbs up!
Thumbs up to 3rd and 21. We just broke through 200 subscribers on YouTube. If you like what you see, please like and subscribe. Write to me at 3rdand21@gmail.com, all spelled out, 3rdand21@gmail.com. Tell me what you think, how we can improve the show, and general thoughts on college football.
Welcome to 3rd and 21, a show where we talk about college football and try to have a little fun. We talk about college football and try to have a little fun. Now back to you, Kemper.
Welcome back. Thank you, Jenny, for the voiceover. This segment brought to you by Superhero Fire Protection, your home for inspection, service, and repair of all things fire protection. Reach out to the good people at Superhero, 678-804-6111. Coach charge, no charge.
National championship game.
National championship game was a dandy, a hard-fought game. And while I was watching it, I got the same feeling I did when I was watching the Peach Bowl, LSU versus Oklahoma. This is all about what LSU did do, not about what Clemson didn't do. When you really start breaking this down, I'm a guy who I cringe when I hear people talking about the greatest, because usually it's just they have a very limited vocabulary, and it's just the latest. It's not the greatest, it's just the latest. But this LSU team, when you break the numbers down, really could be the greatest football season in college football history. From start to finish, there wasn't a clunker of a game in there. The offense, everybody knows about Joe Burrow, 60 touchdowns, the completion percentage. But the way the offense worked in general, scoring 30, 40, 50, 60 points a game, the defense very overlooked because the defense got better and better and better, held Clemson way under their season average. I think that this could be the greatest football season in the history of college football by the LSU Tigers. Clemson Tigers showed the heart of a champion in there. They fought hard, just overmatched. Don't feel too sorry for them. They're already next year's preseason favorite to win the national championship game. Tell you what, quick timeout. When we come back, we will go to the ever-popular mailbag. Hadn't been there in a while. It'll be fun.
Kenny, what were the next sponsor?
K Kenny Whitworth picked LSU. He was right on the money on that one. I like me and Butch.
3, 2.
Welcome back. I want to say thank you to Kenny Whitworth for sponsoring this segment. Kenny will sell it at gmail.com. Official real estate professional of 3rd and 21. Whether you're buying a house, selling a house, buying land, and you want to develop that land, reach out to Kenny. Kenny will sell it at gmail.com. One-stop shop for all things real estate. Kenny will sell it at gmail.com. Tell you what, give me a question.
Greg from Ohio, what did you think of the list at halftime of the all-time greatest players?
Yeah, I thought it was pretty cool. Little disappointed there was only one defensive player on there, but that's somewhat to be expected. Here's the deal. If you make a list, people are going to argue about it. I don't know how you could argue how any of those players couldn't have been even number one. I thought it was a lot of fun.
Chris from Palmetto, how do you rate the Georgia Tech season this year?
First of all, I'm not a Tech fan. I'm not a Tech hater. But if I was a Georgia Tech fan, which I thank my personal God I'm not, but if I was, I'd be pretty happy with the direction of the program. You got 4 wins this year. Most people were picking 1 or 2 wins, one of those being the game against the Citadel, which they didn't win, but you still got 4 wins. Recruiting seems to be going pretty well. I think the general arrow is pointing up for the Tech program, but I'm going to ask the Almanac, who's a big Tech fan, what'd you think of the season?
No comment. Next question, Loretta from Roswell, your take on targeting are asinine, reckless, and toxic.
Wow. Well, thank you, Loretta, for watching. I'll put some thought into your email there. Thank you.
John B. from Saratoga Springs, New York, when do you see somebody else besides Clemson winning the ACC championship? 4 years. What ACC team do you see challenging Clemson in the next 2 years?
Great question. Excellent question, John. The next 4 years, I don't really see anybody. If you're looking for somebody who could step up, your natural reaction is to go to Florida State. Now that they got a coach, maybe he will recruit some offensive linemen. That's the reason Florida State stunk for the last half decade, is they don't have any offensive linemen. But that's going to take them. That's going to take a minute to build up. Miami's in shambles. If you've watched the show, you know I'm a Scott Satterfield fan. He did a great job. Louisville had a nice 8-5 season, coming off a 2-10 from last year. But Louisville's not challenging Clemson. Here's the deal. I think that there might be a team that could beat Clemson on a Saturday, but I don't see any team being able to beat Clemson and run the table to keep them out of the championship game. And I certainly don't see a team that could beat Clemson twice. So prepare yourself. Clemson's going to be in the national championship game, or at least the playoffs, for quite a time to come. Tell you what, that's going to wrap it up for them.
One more question, actually.
Nice. All right.
From Mark J. from Mableton.
Okay.
First time, long time. After watching football all season, I am more baffled than ever as to what is pass interference. To me, it looks like pass interference is on every play, but they only call the easy ones, like walking in the NBA. Pass interference is not being called. What say you? Parentheses, we have personal experience in this, as I was not flagged on in flagrant one. Hashtag admission.
Hashtag admission. Absolutely, Mark. I love it. As far as the question goes, I'm with you on, I am baffled as to what is pass interference, but I'll differ with you on this. I think it's called way too much. Anytime there is an incomplete pass, everybody's looking around for a flag. It's like, if it's incomplete, there was pass interference on it. I think pass interference is called way too much. So put that in your pipe and smoke it. Tell you what, let's take a quick timeout. We come back, we will go to Put Your Money Where Your Mouth Is, see how we did for the season, and wrap this thing up.
Maxi Family Properties, next sponsor. Maxi Family Properties. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Welcome back. I want to say thank you to Maxi Family Properties. You can reach out to Butch at MaxiHomesGA.com, MaxiHomesGA.com. I don't care how much you want to spend on a house. Butch's house starts in the mid-5s, but no matter how much you spend, you will not find a builder who puts more attention into the details. You'll know it when you walk into one of his houses, the building at the Fortress. in Jefferson, Georgia. Long on quality, short on drama. MaxieHomesGA.com.
Put your money where your mouth is.
All right, put your money where your mouth is. The season is over. I've picked games against the spread all season long. How'd we do?
We did 1-1, and now for the whole season, we were 26, 28, and one tie. We were two games under 500.
Two games under 500. We're going to be better next year, I can guarantee you that. But I did give you Louisiana over Miami of Ohio to get us to break even if Clemson would have come through, but they didn't, so. All right. Hey, listen, Uncle Butch will send in a lead pipe lock each week. If you remember, he started out, I think it was 1-4, then went on a absolutely tear of a run. Picked Clemson in the national championship game, finished up 9-8, but overall a pretty darn good season for Butch. Can't wait to do it again next year. Hey, we're going to come back. We're going to do one more show. We're going to do the KPI final, KPI top 12 final for the season. Can't wait to talk about that. One more show. Let's do it. System, 8 players come back on offense. 8 players come back on defense. The front 7 is going to be extremely physical. The back 4 in the secondary are ball hawkers. I want to be just a crazy guy and pick LSU to win the West, but I'm not going to do it because the game is at Alabama.